Now you know that UDP is a very, very simple protocol and its header contains just four fields: source port, destination port, length, and checksum. And basically, UDP itself does not guarantee delivery of data on transport layer of TCP/IP model. And it means that application layer should be responsible for retransmissions if, for example, some segments were lost on the way between two endpoints. But some applications, for example, real-time applications, don't need to retransmit data, because if some part of the sentence that was said by one of the members of the conference was lost somewhere on the way, then there is no need to resend this word later, because conversation goes on and other people start talking. That's why in real-time applications UDP is the best choice, and it is better than TCP. So let's now, using Wireshark, find some UDP segments and analyze them. Let's start a new capture, and now I'll disable my network interface card like that and enable it back again. And now in display filter I'll enter UDP and I should see some UDP segments. Let's stop capture and basically instead of UDP let's find here DHCP protocol packets. Because DHCP basically works over UDP. And now I see here a DHCP request, because now my computer has received the IP address from DHCP server. And let's observe structure of this DHCP request. Same as before, there is Ethernet 2 header, there is IP version 4 header. And inside of this IP version 4 header, there is link to inner protocol. And it is UDP in this case. Let's have a look at UDP header, User Datagram Protocol. And there are just four fields: source port, that is 68, destination port is 67, length is the entire length of UDP header plus data, and here is checksum. And that's basically all fields that are included in header of UDP protocol. And inside of it there is some application data, and in this particular case application layer protocol is DHCP, and here inside you may find DHCP request. And again, please notice source port and destination port. Source port is 68 and destination port is 67. Let's now observe response from the server. Here is basically this response that is sent from source port 67 to destination port 68. Here is again length and checksum, and inside of it there is DHCP related data. DHCP acknowledgement in this particular example. That's how UDP protocol is used by DHCP. Why UDP is used here? Because there is no need to establish TCP connection between client and server just for one request for IP address. That's why UDP is better choice in this particular example. Also, UDP is used for DNS requests. Let's here, instead of DHCP, type DNS like that, and you should see some DNS queries. For example, let's click at any of them. I'll click on this one. And here, again, I see UDP protocol. In IP version 4 header, I see a link to UDP in protocol field. And next, I see UDP protocol that again has just four fields. Source port is random port that was chosen in my case like this. Destination port is 53, it is DNS port, length and checksum. And inside there is DNS related data, and DNS is application layer protocol. And response from remote DNS server goes from port 53 to my local port that I used in DNS request. And again, there is some application data inside. It is actual DNS response from DNS server. That's how UDP is used for DNS. Again, reason why it is used here is that for DNS, we usually send one DNS request and receive DNS reply from the server. No need to establish TCP session, no need to tear down it. Because if we were using here TCP instead of UDP, then we would have at least six different TCP segments. Three segments for establishment of the connection, and three segments for tear down of the TCP connection. And at least one segment would be needed for actual data that should be sent from the server back to client. So in total, seven different TCP segments. That is a waste of network bandwidth and a waste of time, basically, because it takes more time than just to send UDP request and receive response, just two different UDP segments. That's why for some protocols it is better to use UDP instead of TCP. It is faster and it doesn't require any establishment of the connection. That's all for UDP, and next let's summarize what we discussed in this section.